What's up, everyone? Another day, some more bullshit. I don't give a fuck if this safety thing keeps me alive. I'm gonna get this, like, on my next car and be like, take this shit off. Like, take it off. So anyway, today I have to go get a money order. Then I'm gonna go and get a few things. I've been checking IKEA. Like, I ordered a dresser, but I didn't order it until like 2 weeks ago because I wasn't sure if I was gonna be moving in. But now that I've moved in and everything, you know, it was out of stock. So they let me know that it's either in stock or it'll be in stock soon. I'm not sure what the email said, but I think it said a date. So yeah, because I went there and I wanted just like the plain wood one because I was just going to spray paint it, and it was $80 less than buying it, you know, already colored. And then they even had the glaze that they use at the store, and it's only like $4 or $5. So I could actually go to Home Depot, tell them that I'm moving out of my apartment and that I need like a, you know, just like a small can of paint, and they will give it to me for like $4 or $5. And it's a big can of paint. Like, it'll do it, and they'll fill it up for you right then. So yeah, I'm probably gonna go there and do that. I have a lot of other shit that I need to get done. Like, I need to get a little bit of groceries and stuff. I'm gonna buy my scale today, so yeah. And they just built an In-N-Out in West Campus. Like, the fuck? It's crazy. That was very much needed. They're late. Not just kidding. No, but like, honestly, Austin has like 5 In-N-Outs. They need to build one in Houston. Like, once they do that, like, everybody else is going out of business because it is so good. I'm just trying to figure out, why is In-N-Out so good, but a big ass chain like Burger King is so nasty? Like, where do they do these? Why is it like this? I really don't get it. Anyway, guys, it's Sunday. Happy Sunday. Is it Sunday? Yeah, today is Sunday. I think so. It's been a week since I've gone out to the club, y'all. This week went by so fast. Like, and today is like a no foundation day. I just put my K-pop Rouge and my Milani. I think it's, I forgot what it's called, but it's that one I'm always wearing. Oh, and actually this is, I think this color is K, because it's the brown one. So yeah, I just made it to the bank. I got on my little jacket. This jacket, I've had it for years. I bought it at Macy's when I was working there. It's so crazy how like places treat their employees so shitty, but like, we spend so much money at the place that we work. Like, if I'm working at Party City, I'm spending a lot of my money there. If I'm working at Macy's, I'm spending a lot of my money there, you know, because you're always seeing shit that you like. But Macy's treats their employees like shit, and like, a lot of people on YouTube who talk about working there, like, they did not fucking like it. And I got fired for something stupid. So I just filmed my foster care story, and that should be going up today. Like, it's definitely going up today, and so is like 2 or 3 vlogs. I haven't posted a vlog since the 2nd, and today is like the 8th, and like, everything's recorded, it just needs to be edited. So I re-recorded the foster care story, and I mean, I don't really like the way that I look in the videos. That's the only problem that I usually have, but it's okay. I'm like, whatever. Oh, I need to call my mom. Like, she called me this morning, and I told her, I was like, I'm gonna call you back, and I have not called her back, so let me do that. Okay, just left Target. Now I'm gonna head over to HEB. There's actually one by my house. Like, and there was a Chase. So I only came to Target to see if they had the hangers on sale. They're not. So I'm just gonna put everything in my dresser when I get that. I was just on the phone with my mom. Speaking of parents, guys. Okay, so I just posted a video about my dad. If you guys haven't seen it, you guys can check out. I've been posting main channel videos. I posted a few. Now that this video has gone up, so you guys can check that. And people keep thinking that in my pregnancy video that I was talking to my dad. And I never said that. And I'm like, where the fuck are y'all getting that from? I never, ever said that. Ever. Ever. I, like, what the, have any of you guys ever heard me say, hey guys, just talking to my dad? Like, no, all you guys ever said is my mom. Like, in the caption, I even said the dad. I was talking about the child's dad. I wasn't talking about my dad. And then I said my brother. how people miss that. Like, that just shows you guys, social media, when you don't even have to, like, pay super hard attention. Like, it's right there. You don't even have to read between the lines. You can be saying something, have it in closed caption, and have big words saying the thing. Because I literally put the dad, because I knew that people were going to misconstrue it somehow, and they did. And so on my video, people are commenting saying, wait a minute, trying to catch me in a lie. They're saying stuff like, your dad was the first person you called when you were pregnant. And I was like, what? And then I saw one comment like that. So I was like, okay, whatever. Then I saw two comments and I was like, okay, whatever. Somebody else agreeing with them. And I'm like, how am I think that I'm just talking to my dad like that? Then it's like, if you think that, okay, whatever. But then you're kind of like, they're accusatory, because they're like, wait a minute. So people are pretty much saying that I'm lying. Like, bitch, this is YouTube. I am not about to lie for y'all. I'm sorry. Like, this place is not my life. And there are so many things I could be doing fucking desperate, like making racist videos and putting cum on my face for a challenge. Okay? Y'all really think that people are so desperate for views? Like, get the fuck out of here. There are so many things I could do. Like, I could make into my entire channel fake pranks and then call it a day and go get me a Bugatti. Shit. The fuck out of here. Okay, and then fucking quit YouTube after that, because y'all love falling for them fake ass pranks. Like, everything is a fail. All the pranks you ever see are fails, because they already know it's going to be a fail, and people like failing pranks, which is fucking weird. It just really pisses me off, because it's like, what the fuck is wrong with some of y'all? I'm going to have to make a main channel video addressing this, because, like, I don't understand why people do shit like this. Like, why? And you know what? And here's my thing. I don't even complain about the fake shit that I see on YouTube, because YouTube is literally a survival of the fittest. Like, there's enough room for all of us, but people don't act like it. So you see a lot of desperate ass people on there. But if you guys notice, the people that do obvious fake shit, live fake lives, they're making the most money. Numbers don't lie. So quit trying to act like y'all don't like fake shit, and you do. So stop fucking complaining. Like, let's just say my shit was fake and that I was lying about having a relationship with my dad. Who fucking cares? Y'all love the fake shit anyway, so why the fuck are y'all trying to act like you don't like it? Even if it was fake. Shit. You like it. Stop lying. Okay? I could literally lie and carry on a life of no, and acting like hey guys, just got off the phone with my dad. I could totally do that. And then what difference is it gonna make? But it's easier to tell the truth, because I'm bad at lying, so you would easily catch me in a lie. But sometimes, you know, y'all just be reaching. Some people reach. It's just annoying, because it's like, if you don't hear something, okay, that's fine. But then to be like, wait a minute, I thought you said, and try to catch me in a lie, that's a whole nother thing. You're not catching shit. There's no lie to catch, because you read it wrong. So now you're going to comment publicly, and then people on a forum think that. And y'all, that's what gets me too. Like, people would actually go into a forum and, like, believe that versus what the actual truth is. Like, I don't get people. And you know what? I don't even want to. I'm good. I don't get people, and I don't want to get people. My relationships with humans is good, because I don't want to understand nobody. Okay, not all of y'all are crazy, but there's a very good amount. A very good amount of crazy on YouTube. Another thing I want to talk about is people saying that YouTubers are crazy or whatever. Like, if y'all don't shut the fuck up. I'm always seeing people saying shit about, like, why are YouTubers so depressed and so crazy? Because we're human beings and we decided to put ourselves on YouTube. Most of y'all motherfuckers are going through the same thing. You're just not putting it out there. That solves it right there. That should end any conspiracy theory that YouTubers are crazy, because there is no difference. We're literally people just like y'all. We just so happen to become YouTubers. That's it. That's fucking it. Literally. And people think that it's YouTube. No, boo. No. YouTube covers up a lot of people's problems, because, you know, they're just doing stuff on video. But some of y'all are walking around killing people, and then you want to say, oh, YouTubers are crazy. No, bitch, you're crazy, okay? You're crazy. You just don't have a YouTube channel, so nobody can say, oh, you're a YouTuber who's crazy. But, bitch, that makes no difference. The only difference in life is that I decided to upload a video. That's it. if I'm gonna be crazy, I'll be crazy on and off of YouTube. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of these people are fucking crazy, you know? And it's not, like somebody was saying, like, oh, we post videos because we're insecure. We post videos because there's a lot of good info out there. And a lot of people, and that's just it. I mean, and we're obviously entertaining somebody, so we're posting videos. Call that a day. Like, X that out. Try again. Like, some of these people, I'd be like, erase that. Try again. Do it all over because you're wrong. Like, that's what I'd be thinking. You guys know what is annoying about having everything right where you live? Not being able to go far. I like to drive, and everything is literally like walking distance or like an Uber drive, a cheap ass Uber drive away, or I could just bike. And that's annoying. Like, I have no car block because everywhere I go is literally like down the street unless there's traffic. And I'm always in the house. So now when I see when people are saying shit like, oh, I want a place that like, that is such a, somebody has a cute white Jeep that they like kind of like put little like hints of pink, and it's really cute. So the good thing is that last night people were not so loud and drunk and crazy outside of my window, so that's good. Usually, because last night was Saturday night, usually people are inconsiderate, loud, screaming, like just being idiots and stuff outside. I wonder what is this. And last night, because it was so cold, it's been so cold these last couple of days, Friday and Saturday, I almost didn't know what day it was because the way that I can tell what day it is if there are a bunch of people just out. And even like today, like people are out like in the street because it's Sunday fun day. People but it's nothing like the summertime. The summertime is gonna be crazy. Summertime is gonna be real crazy. But yeah, and there was nobody really out last night, and that was really interesting. Okay, I don't think I need GPS for this. I don't think so. I'm going to the HEB down here, so hopefully I can, fingers crossed, do this. Guys, ever since I got that pizza, it was a barbecue, it was like a Tennessee or something like that barbecue pizza. It had chicken, onions, barbecue sauce, mushrooms, extra cheese, extra sauce with bacon. Guys, that pizza along with Long John Silver's is going to be at my wedding. Like, it was crazy. It was so good. And I've been thinking, and it was on like a flatbread. Ever since then, y'all, I have been thinking about that pizza. Now, they could have put extra stuff on it because I asked them for like extra meat, and they didn't really put extra meat on there. I was like, so next time if they don't put extra meat, and if I'm not happy with the pizza, I'm gonna have them remake it. Like, there have been too many times where I've walked away from things and I was just like so unhappy with it that I didn't really want to bother people. But now I'm about to be cheap. It's not even called being cheap, it's just getting what you paid for. The pizza that I got the other night, like, even though I was really happy with it, guys, like, it did not have enough shit on it. And that really kind of like pissed me off. I just love the area that I live in. I'm just so happy. Like, I just love it. Ugh, so happy. Yesterday or the day before, I was just kind of like going through something. And I was thinking to myself, like, maybe I should have moved to the apartment that was like by not too far away from Houston. But then, like, I just thought about it and I was like, nah. I would not be having like the amount of fun that I'm having. Even though I would have gotten like 3 times the square footage, you know what I mean? It doesn't beat this. Like, it doesn't beat what I plan on doing this year. So that's why I'm just like, I'm good. Like, my cost of living would have been lower, you know, just everything. But it doesn't beat it. And that's how I am. Like, I am one of those people, if I know something is worth it, I have no problem in waiting. Like, I am willing to wait if I feel like it's worth it. So, and my peace and happiness is so much more worth than saving a couple $100. Like, 197.6. Well, on the bright side, at least I'm under the 200 mark. I was 200 like a few days ago. Like, no, a week ago I was 200. So I'm losing it a little bit.
Okay, so I'll just do like a quick grocery haul of some things that I got. They have the Greek yogurt on sale. It was like $3.60, but Greek yogurt is a lot less fattening than regular yogurt. Like the one that I usually buy, like it has like a total fat of like 3, and then half of it's saturated, and then it has double the calories. So I bought Greek yogurt. It's a lot more heavy too, a lot heavier, and it was only $2.75. So I'm gonna mix that into my smoothies. I got a gallon of water so I can boil my noodles. I got some spaghetti, like tomato Alfredo sauce. And I got me a 1 liter so that I don't crash and buy like a bunch of expensive little sodas like I've been buying. I got some kombucha so that I don't want to drink soda. Kombucha is pretty much just the process of the soda. It's fermented, but it's way more acidic than soda. It has 45 calories in the entire bottle. It has 4 grams of sugar. It has no fat, no sodium, no protein. This is a very bland soda. So if you guys are looking for something that's flavored, but like don't ever get those like 99% fat-free or those fat-free sodas. Those are worse than diet drinks. They're really, really bad. They actually contain aspartame, which is really bad for you. So don't ever get those like fake sodas from the store. Get you a kombucha. They're usually 100% organic, and they have no flavor, honestly. I'll be honest with y'all, but this is really, it's better than the sparkling waters, because those just like, it's better, but the sparkling waters have like nothing in them. So it's either this, a little bit of flavor, which is bitter, or the sparkling waters. See, I got those, and do not shake these up. Like I said, these are more acidic than these. So if you shake them even just like a little bit, even if you just tilt it to the side, it will start to bubble up. So watch out for that. I've already tasted them. I really don't like these. And they actually have better kombuchas, but these were $2 for $2.50 because they were on sale, but I won't get one free. But usually kombuchas are about $3 to $7. So they're expensive also. I got me like 2 pounds of bananas. I got those dinner mints, which are the death of me. But usually I buy 2 packs, only bought one. The bell peppers were $3 for $1, which is pretty cheap. So I got 2. Got me some tomatoes. Garlic, finally. I haven't had garlic in weeks and I miss it. And then I got me a pack of this. It was only $1.78 at the HEB by my house. Then I got 2 of these things of strawberry. And that was it. I mean, tonight I'm just going to probably have me some chicken breast with no, I'll tell you guys, I got these chicken breasts over at Target that goes in the sink. Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you guys. I also bought me cheese. I don't buy the whole pack of cheese. I buy, like, I got 2 slices of variety cheese to go on my, like a half of 1 slice is gonna go on my spaghetti. But yeah, this is the chicken fillets, the chicken breast fillets, and they're skinless. Like up to 100% retained water, so that's good. Hand trimmed. It says no added hormones. Who knows? It's not organic, but since it's been inspected, so yeah. It came with 3. I cut them in half usually, and I'll eat like 1 for like lunch and 1 for dinner. But I don't eat after 7, and I've stopped like starving myself. So yeah. If I get really hungry tonight, I'll have me like a strawberry, like banana smoothie. But tonight, for dinner, I'm going to have chicken and Alfredo. Because I'm also not trying to eat out. I really want to know what's going on in my body. And I also got some clothes hangers because I needed them. I think I'm done with the clothes hangers. Everything else is just going to have to go into the dresser. Just making chicken breasts. So, as usual, I cut them in half. So, now it's just 4 pieces. I have my bell pepper, garlic, vegetable oil, and just like seasoning as usual with the onion. And I'm just gonna start frying it up. And then the pot over there is for the spaghetti. Here we go. Okay, so right now I'm just frying up the chicken breast. I've seasoned them and I accidentally put it up a little bit too high, but that's okay. Yes, I'm just using my salt, pepper, garlic powder mixture, and then I'm going to cut up some vegetables and just, whoops, that's okay. Never too much of that. Just kind of like mix those things in.
Guess I better start cutting up. So first I'm just gonna add my bell pepper. The plates are getting ready to be washed, so that's why I'm not using them, and I don't even have a cutting board, so there's that. But yeah, I'm just cutting it like that. Eek. Watching Girlfriends and Tony's getting married.
Yes, it's Chelsea.
Not just because Tony and
okay, so I just got done with my spaghetti and now I'm just folding it all in there. Usually I let the like spaghetti kind of like cook into there a little bit. So it can be nice and saturated. But like if you kind of just put it on there afterwards, it's more of like a marinara type of thing. A little bit difficult with one hand. Yeah, the food's really good. I cooked the chicken first, and you know, of course, I seasoned it and everything, and put that all in there. I want like some spinach in there to kind of cook down, so I want a few pieces. Oh, you know what? Maybe I should just make a salad. I could totally do that. Salad would be really good. For SWV, there was no slowing down. Thanks in part to their